My name is Taylor Pinsent. I'm calling from Multnomah County Public Health. I'm calling you regarding some important health information. I want to make sure I have the right person. Can you please confirm your date of birth? The person then confirms their date of birth, and then we move on with saying, you know, you've been reported to us with a positive COVID-19 lab. If I had a case reported, a positive case of COVID-19, we would call that person and we ask questions about when they would have been exposed, so the 2 weeks before, and then what we call their contagious period, which starts the 2 days before their symptom onset. Because what we're trying to determine is where they could have been exposed, and then we want to know who they exposed. So those are kind of our two big goals of a case investigation. Let's say it's a sporadic community acquired case. I can't quite pinpoint where they would have been exposed. We now shift to who they would have exposed. And so, you know, I might say, okay, starting on May 26th, you know, what did you do that day? When you got up in the morning, where did you go? Did you go to work that day? What hours do you typically work? You know, who do you work next to? And so if they went to work in landscaping and they say, yeah, I show up at work, I meet my partner, we get in the car, and then we go do our jobs, and it's all outside open air. For that example, you know, we would collect the name and phone number of that coworker who rode in the car with the person, and we would call that person and follow up with them. And with anything, when you think of science and how we do our investigations, we can't ever say, oh, 100%, you know, this is zero risk. We usually say, okay, that's a lower risk type of situation. So, for example, if that case tells me I went to work from 6 to 6, on my way home, I stopped and picked up, you know, a pack of hot dogs, and then I went home. Well, them stopping at the store, walking in, wearing a cloth face covering, picking up a pack of hot dogs, checking out and heading home is not as high risk exposure as the person they were sitting in the car spending the entire day with. So would we do a public notification to Fred Meyer or whatever grocery store they went to? Probably not, because it's a lot lower risk. So that's what we're kind of constantly doing as we do these contact investigations. We kind of follow that same logic if it was a family gathering. Let's say everyone got together on, I don't know, Mother's Day, and we have aunts and uncles and grandchildren and all kinds of people coming together and spending an entire day in a home. We would then go through and get the names and phone numbers of every single person who is at that party to then follow up with them. And you'll often, with COVID, it's very contagious when you have that closer contact. I might also see those folks come through with a positive lab. Our goal is to slow down that spread and isolate it as much as possible. Again, the ultimate goal of preventing surge in a hospital system where they can't handle the number of patients. With contact tracing, it allows us to intervene from a public health perspective as much as possible. Meaning, if you know you've been exposed and you're supposed to watch for symptoms for the next 2 weeks, you generally stay home. And then that kind of stops or cuts off the transmission as much as possible.